Within the United States, one of the many beautiful geologic wonders in the western section of the country is Meteor Crater in Arizona. This 50,000-year-old impact crater is the single best-preserved impact crater on the entire planet, which is why, in my opinion, everyone should visit it at some point. However, this is not the only large impact crater within the country. Another large impact crater is located in a place many people would not expect. Iowa. This several million-year-old large crater went undiscovered until 1959 since it is buried by more than 100 feet of glacial sediments deposited during the Pleistocene glacial periods. Once revealed, it was measured at 22 miles or 35 kilometers wide and 2,200 feet deep. Known as Manson Crater, it formed during a catastrophic impact event so large that today, many tens of millions of years later, it still affects the area's water table. Approximately 74.1 million years ago, the Earth was a much warmer planet. At the time, western Iowa was the site of a temperate inland sea which stretched from Texas to the Arctic. It contained numerous fish and giant reptile species such as the 30-foot-long plesiosaur. Meanwhile, a large asteroid made its final approach towards the planet. This asteroid measured 1.15 miles or 1.85 kilometers wide. It was not particularly dense, which relates to its formation 4.5 billion years ago. In the early solar system, particles of rocks the size of sand and cobbles merged together due to the force of gravity, forming small asteroids. Known as chondrites, these types of asteroids, when viewed up close, contain numerous small spheres of material clumped together. More than 85% of all meteorites which entered the Earth's atmosphere are chondrites, and while unconfirmed, I personally suspect that the impactor had a Type H chondrite composition. As this asteroid entered the upper atmosphere, it was traveling at 17 kilometers per second or 38,000 miles per hour. Only a few seconds later, this asteroid struck what is now western Iowa, generating a massive explosion equivalent in energy to the detonation of 394,000 megatons of TNT. This created a massive fireball which vaporized a large section of the inland sea it struck and thousands of feet of its underlying limestone and dolostone. It was so intense that it caused all plant and animal life within a 235 mile radius, in other words, all of Iowa that wasn't underwater, to ignite. As the associated shockwave expanded outwards, all trees in a 280 mile or 450 kilometer radius were flattened, pointing away from the impact site. As a large tsunami was created due to the impact, a magnitude 8.3 earthquake was generated. This was large enough to be felt more than 1,000 miles away in what is now Phoenix, Boise, and New York City. These areas soon received a dusting of impact ash. After the dust cleared, what remained was a 22-mile or 35-kilometer-wide impact crater. Despite the proximity of this impact event to the eventual extinction of the non-avian dinosaurs, it did not cause any mass extinctions. Life soon after recovered, although the crater has left a permanent feature in the subsurface. The area surrounding the town of Manson in Iowa has unusually soft water which largely does not have abundant minerals such as calcium and magnesium. This is strange as the rest of the state contains hard water. The reason for this is that the impact vaporized a large quantity of limestone and dolostone, meaning today those non-existent rock units cannot add abundant hard water associated minerals within the crater's radius. I hope that you found this video interesting. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, E.L. Frederick, for supporting my work.